For over a decade, the diesel trucking industry has been using a post-combustion exhaust emission control system called an aftertreatment system. This system is designed to reduce two major types of emissions, particulate emissions and oxides of nitrogen.
Particulate emissions are smoke. Oxides of nitrogen are one of the significant constituents of greenhouse gases and smog. For this video, we will only address particulate emissions.
The Paccar diesel aftertreatment system consists of four major elements with their support subsystems.
As the exhaust gases enter the aftertreatment system, they first encounter the diesel oxidation catalyst, or DOC. The small quantities of unburned particulates from the combustion process are combined with the residual oxygen from the combustion process in a catalytic environment to produce heat.
Supporting the DOC is the HC, or hydrocarbon doser. Its job is to spray small quantities of diesel fuel into the exhaust ahead of the DOC when leftover hydrocarbons from combustion are insufficient to produce the right amount of heat.
From the DOC, the exhaust gases pass on to the diesel particulate filter, or DPF. As the name implies, the job of the DPF is to filter out the residual particulates that result from combustion. These particles are extremely small, but represent a significant contribution to air pollution. The DPF is a very fine filter that traps these particles while allowing the air to pass through freely.
The two major constituents of these particles are soot and ash. Soot is a particle of less than 2/100,000 of an inch in diameter, and ash is even smaller. The soot and ash are trapped in the DPF, and over time begin to restrict the flow of exhaust gases through the DPF. This can limit performance of the engine.
Under normal operating conditions, the exhaust gases support the oxidation of the soot to a gas. Just driving keeps the DPF regenerated. This is referred to as passive regeneration. There are times, however, when soot production is greater than normal while heat production is lower than normal. Under these conditions, soot will begin to build up and the DPF will begin to restrict. When this happens, the system will begin to add hydrocarbons through the HC doser. This is called an active regeneration, and it occurs without the driver being aware it is happening. In the most extreme of cases, with reduced load conditions and high particulate production, such as during extended idle, the driver may be asked by various warning lamps and driver display messages to perform a parked regeneration. The engine and aftertreatment control system is designed to notify the driver when the system needs the driver's attention through a set of lamps or warning messages. The remote diagnostic system also provides notifications. These are designed to be more predictive than those on the truck to provide an advance alert to those monitoring the remote diagnostic system. The in-truck warnings provide the best and most timely indication of the current state of the diesel particulate filter. This icon will illuminate when the DPF needs to be regenerated. It does not mean that a stationary regeneration needs to be done, only that some form of regeneration needs to be done. The easiest solution, if the day's schedule permits, is to get the truck up to freeway speeds and load conditions for several minutes. Of course, if freeway driving is not in the plan for the day, then a stationary regeneration may be the solution. If it is needed, performing a parked regeneration is easy. Begin by parking the truck in a safe location, where no one will be in the immediate vicinity of the tailpipe, and with nothing combustible within 5 feet in any direction of the exhaust. This will require an observant walk around the truck. Make sure the parking brake is applied, the engine is at a low idle, the DPF warning lamp is illuminated or flashing, the engine coolant is at operating temperature, the throttle is released, the brake and clutch are not applied, the PTO is not engaged, the cruise control is off, and the transmission is in neutral or park. Now push and hold the DPF button for at least 4 to 8 seconds. The regeneration will not start immediately. After releasing the DPF button, it may take 30 seconds or more for the system to complete a series of self-checks and start the actual regeneration. Once initiated, if you need to stop a regeneration for safety or any other reason, simply depress the brake pedal or accelerator pedal or turn off the regeneration switch. There are three lamps in addition to the DPF lamp that are also important to the DPF and regeneration process. First is the malfunction indicator lamp, or MIL. When this lamp illuminates, it should not be considered an emergency, but recognize that it indicates the truck may be out of EPA compliance. If it does not go out after engine operating conditions allow for a passive regeneration, or after performing a parked regeneration, then it is advisable to consult your service team for options. The stop engine lamp will illuminate when a perceived major engine problem exists. As related to regeneration, it will illuminate when the soot level in the DPF reaches its maximum level. At this point, there is nothing you can do as the driver to regenerate the DPF. It must be done by a service facility. But remember, it will only get to this point when there is a repairable problem and earlier warnings were ignored. The High Exhaust System Temperature Warning Lamp, or HEST lamp, is a warning that the exhaust temperature is high. It most frequently illuminates during long, high engine load events. However, it can also illuminate after any form of regeneration. It does not indicate a problem. When it is illuminated, it indicates that the truck should not be within 5 feet of any combustible material, and that the exhaust may be hot enough to cause injury.
The After Treatment Operator's Manual has more information on regeneration and related warning lights. It is recommended to read the manual for best practices in the operation of your truck.